It's time to turn our attention to one of several different projects led by somebody who's been involved with It's Friday since its very beginning. It's great to have Killick back with us on this occasion, along with the trio. It's sometimes a quartet, I believe, but today it's a trio, Pocketful of Claptonite.
We are very glad to be here. Thank you very much.
Shall we begin?
Absolutely.
Pocket full of Claptonite here on It's Friday. Would you care to tell us anything about what we just heard, or should it just speak for itself?
Well, I suppose it is open to interpretation.
Well, isn't everything?
Yes.
It's great to have you back on It's Friday one more time. You always give us something to puzzle over. among other things. I was looking at your website earlier, which is killick.me.
Yes.
There's a page there where you're talking about your own influences, and you name some musicians who are familiar names. Name some that are totally unfamiliar to me, but John and Alice Coltrane are certainly names I know, and Sun Ra, and Joni Mitchell, and Neil Young, and Black Sabbath, and Gordon Lightfoot, Philip Glass, The Police. These are musical influences of the sort we're accustomed to, but then you also say, the primary sound influences on Killick are animals, wind, water, fire, electrical hum.
But not too much.
Yeah, and silence. And of course, silence is always an important part of music, even when it's absent.
Absolutely. So I suppose this is what happens when you put all of those influences together simultaneously, all at once, in tandem with other people who feel the same way.
So I guess my question, the one that I've kind of always tried to find a way to pose to you, and still haven't, but I'll make one more attempt at it, is how did you arrive at that point where you bring all those influences to bear?
It all began 42 years ago in New Jersey, and and then just a series of cumulative events. I can't really explain it.
Sure, but that's life, I believe, is what you were just saying. Okay, that's fair enough. I have to mention also, it is great to have along with you Jamie DeRevere on drums, Darrin Cook on bass, who have appeared on It's Friday in many different combinations over the years. For a long time, I think you guys held the record for most appearances in different ensembles, although I think of late Adam Pullen has probably topped you on that.
How many more weeks do you have of It's Friday?
There are five more after this one.
Okay, so there's a chance.
That could be if they're cancellations. Well, that's enough talk for now. How about some more music?
All righty.
pocket full of Claptonite here on this Friday. I think for the benefit of our radio listeners who didn't see what was happening there, I should point out that what you heard that sounded like drums pretty much was the drums. What you heard that sounded like a double bass pretty much was the bass. And everything else you heard was produced by Killick's guitar and the bank of devices connected to it.
The mothership is responsible for most of what you heard.
You have been known to bring some very unusual instruments with you, although on this occasion you're playing what appears to be a fairly conventional guitar. You can tell me to what extent I'm wrong about that.
So this is a fretless guitar, so no bumps in the road,
uh-huh.
And no orientation whatsoever.
yeah. It's as microtonal as you want it to be.
As microtonal as you want it to be. Actually, muscle memory serves very effectively. But mm-hmm. The fun thing is to color in between the lines, you know, and
sure.
Outside the box.
Sure. Well, I mean, after all, that's what Darren's doing all the time, right?
Yes.
Or anybody playing a member of the violin or
violin
or cello,
family. Absolutely.
So what's the big deal there? But still, it's a different way to approach it.
Yeah, no, it's fun. And actually, this instrument was made by a good friend, formerly of New Jersey, currently of Texas, Rick Toon, and it has a fretted neck as well. I can change it out if I like.
Ah, yeah. Okay. So quite a bit of versatility there.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Why don't we proceed?
Okay. Thank you.
Pocketful of Claptonite here on It's Friday. Well, Killick, there's a subject I want to bring up with you. I think you're aware that much of what you do is kind of unconventional, and people have different reactions to it. There are some folks out there who are scratching their heads and saying, "Wait, this is music," and there are probably a few who've just turned it off in disgust. But there's probably Go ahead.
I'm worried all this is happening while people are driving home from work. So
yeah, well see, that's why it's good the show's on a little earlier than it used to be. But you know, there's probably somebody out there who totally gets what you're doing and is into it and thinking, that is so cool. I want to be just like him. What's your reaction to that?
I feel as if what we do is it's just something. It's just a genuine expression, and it really has no. There's just no agenda with it, and it's an open presentation, and it's given freely. And I hope people get something out of it, and if they don't, that's fine too. You know, maybe it answers, or it asks more questions than it answers.
Yeah,
which is fine with me.
Yeah, well, I guess the thing I'd like to point out, although I know you can be very self-deprecating and humorous about what you're doing and about people's reactions to it. I think I'm correct when I say this is very serious to you, and you do absolutely mean what you're doing. And my impression is. You are very demanding of yourself, that this is as close as you can get to the way you want it to sound, and you're probably not quite satisfied with it yet. Sometimes.
I'm happy with it generally, and
good.
But it takes a lot of practice and a lot of maintenance to get to this point. Which may not be apparent because it's outside of the boundaries of conventional Western.
Right.
Musical presentation, and that's become the world standard. You know, even other countries have been heavily influenced by Western recording techniques, and everything being locked to grid and being in 4/4, and you know, in certain keys with strict adherence to certain tonalities. And this is an exploration of what lies outside of that. All of that is wonderful, and of course, that's what I listen to primarily, just like everybody else. But there's something within me that that wants to make some other sounds known, and you know, if it comes across as humorous, that's fine, and I would like it to be have some levity and be fun, and but there is a sort of there's a serious aspect to it as well, you know, and this is pretty much this is my obsession, and you know, I haven't given up yet.
Well, this particular setting, given even the name itself is there's a bit of a pun in that.
Sure.
Pocketful of Claptonite. This seems to be a setting that you've used for a little more humor than perhaps some of your other efforts.
My fellow bandmates in Pocketful of Claptonite are very funny people. So, this lets us be ourselves.
And the other question I wanted to pose to you is. It does seem to me that with age, and I think you referred earlier to your being now in early in your fifth decade, it does seem to me you've mellowed a bit. Do you think so?
Musically?
Yeah.
I would say I've learned to relax musically.
Yeah. Okay.
I think that's the big thing. As far as mellowing outside of playing music, I do enjoy naps more than I used to.
Oh, you'll come to enjoy them even more with the passage of time. No doubt about that. Well, let's, before we get back to music, we'll, and probably to conclude the show, we'll have about 4 minutes left. Let me take care of the usual closing things.
All right.
First of which is thanking you for being on It's Friday on this occasion and so many other occasions in the past.
And I would love to thank you on behalf of Pocketful of Claptonite and my other groups, Crazy Horse and Thunderome. Thank you very much for the support over the years. And Athens has a real treasure in you, and it will be a very hard act to follow.
Well, thank you. Thank you. Let me thank a few other folks as well. I certainly want to thank Caroline Aiken for joining us earlier on this show, as well as those who make it happen. Andy Rehm, our engineer, master control operators, Martin Matheny and Doug Brown. Todd Dickey handled studio preparation and operates the Chiron and has been doing a lot of other things on this show. Our camera operators are all pros filling in for our music business students since the semester is over now. So thanks to Jeff, Alexia, Todd, and Andy, all of them doing multiple roles in making this happen. It's Friday is directed by Steve Bell. It's a joint production of WUGA, the university's broadcast and video department, and the UGA Music Business Program. And thanks to you for joining us. Hope you'll be back when It's Friday returns in another 7 days with music by Brian Bloodworth and Hog-Eyed Man. And now, back to Killick, who, by the way, is going to be appearing at Go Bar on Friday, June 5th. That's not Pocketful of Claptonite. This is you and one other
and
person.
And a cellist named Alec Livaditis, and it'll be a lot of fun. Okay. Both fretless.
Nothing to fret about. Okay.
No fretting.
All right, let's hear some more from Pocketful of Claptonite. Thank you.